For that, I'll have to give a little bit background about different types of realization and what is the type of communication. So yoga marga and jnana marga. Yeradu margagalu. Yoga marga mattu vichara marga. ಯೋಗ ಮಾರ್ಗದಲ್ಲಿ ಕರ್ಮಯೋಗ ಕರ್ಮ ಯೋಗ ಭಕ್ತಿಯೋಗ ಜ್ಞಾನಯೋಗ ಕ್ರಿಯಾಯೋಗ ಇದು ನಾಲ್ಕು ದಾರಿಗಳು ಯೋಗ ಮಾರ್ಗದಲ್ಲಿ. ಸೊ ಯೋಗ ಮಾರ್ಗದ ಉದ್ದೇಶ ಚಿತ್ತಶುದ್ಧಿ. ಚಿತ್ತಶುದ್ಧಿ is the purpose of yoga marga. Making your mind silent and purify yourself. Okay. Ega, for example, I gave some work for you, people, Gayatri and Smita. I gave assignment to you. What is the assignment?
Teaching.
What is the assignment given to you?
Recording.
So all these are sadhana for purification. That comes under karma yoga. Okay, karma yoga. Then vichara marga is what I teach. Any path you go, karma yoga, bhakti yoga, jnana yoga, kriya yoga, finally you have to come to vichara. The vichara is the dead end. After that nothing is there. Illi enagutte ee margadalli the focus is on doing and doership. Doing with the attitude of non-doership. Beko. Yella ee yoga marga anta helkondu doership ide. Oh, I am studying scriptures. Who is there? The one who is studying is there. No, I am doing service. I am doing service is there. So then you say, I try to do service as an offering to Guru. Ultimately, you are trying to purify yourself. Shuddhi madlik, try madti that. So I am doing bhajan of Bhagavan. So who is there? I am there. Right? I am there. So vichara marga, the purpose is to remove the I am. Okay? Vichara marga is to remove I am by removing, by inquiring. Into nature of doership, enjoyership, and knowership. Arthakriya? Which ee karma yoga, bhakti yoga, jnana yoga madadalli nanu maartta idanta bhavane idde irthadalli. I am doer. Okay? And you understand? I am doing. Okay, I studied one scripture. I want to study more scripture. I am doing service. I want to do more service. Right? The purpose is there for you to remove the feeling of ego. But it doesn't go. Pogalam. So this is where they finally come to a jnana marga. This is what is meant by Shri Krishna says, Bahunam Janmanamante Jnanaman Maham Prabhadidi. This is the path. Madam, this is not the traditional interpretation of Vedanta. So Vedanta, ಏನ್ ಮಾಡ್ತಾರೋ ಜ್ಞಾನವನ್ನು ಇಲ್ಲೇ ಎಸರಿಸ್ತಾರೆ.
ಓಕೆ ಐ ಡೋಂಟ್ ಎಕ್ಸೆಪ್ಟ್ ದಟ್ ಸೊ ದಟ್ಸ್ ಆ್ಯಕ್ಚುಲಿ ನೇತಿ 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 ಸ್ಟ್ರೈಟ್ ಆಗಿ ಕೊಟ್ಟದ್ದು ರೂಟ್ ಆಫ್ ಈಗೋ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಭಾಳ ಎಲ್ಲ ಇದೆಲ್ಲ ಮುಗಿಸ್ಕೊಂಡು ಇರ್ಬಾರ್ದು ದಟ್ ಇಸ್ ದ ಮೈ ವ್ಯೂ ಓಕೆ ಸೊ ಹಿಯರ್ ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ನೇತಿ ನೇತಿ ಸ್ಟ್ರೈಟ್ ಆಗಿ ನೇತಿ 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 ಬಟ್ ನೇತಿ ನೇತಿ ತ್ರೂ ಎನ್ಕ್ವೈರಿ ಥ್ರೂ ಎನ್ಕ್ವೈರಿ ನಾಟ್ ದಿಸ್ ಯು ಆರ್ ಎಲಿಮಿನೇಟಿಂಗ್ ಓಕೆ ಆಯ್ತಾ ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಏನಾಗಿದೆ ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ಆ್ಯಕ್ಚುಲಿ ಎ ಪ್ರೊಸೆಸ್ ಆ್ಯಕ್ಚುಲಿ ಐ ಡೋಂಟ್ ಯೂನ್ ಕಾಲ್ ದಿಸ್ ಅ ಪ್ರೊಸೆಸ್ ಆ್ಯಕ್ಚುಲಿ ಪ್ರೊಸೆಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಪ್ಯೂರಿಫಿಕೇಶನ್ ಎಂಡಿಂಗ್ ಆಫ್ ದಿ ಪ್ರೊಸೆಸ್ ಕ್ಲಿಯರ್ ಅರ್ಥ ಆಯ್ತು ಸೊ ದ ಪ್ರೊಸೆಸ್ ಈಸ್ ದೇರ್ ಬಿಕಾಸ್ ಈಗೋ ಈಸ್ ಅ ಪ್ರೊಸೆಸ್ ಈಗೋ ಇಸ್ ನಾಟ್ ಎಂಟಿಟಿ ಇಟ್ಸ್ ಕಂಟಿನ್ಯೂಸ್ಲಿ ಈಸ್ ಅ ಪ್ರೊಸೆಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಬಿಕಮಿಂಗ್ ಈಗೋ ಈಸ್ ಇನ್ ದ ಪ್ರೊಸೆಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಬಿಕಮಿಂಗ್ ಈಗ ಈಗ ಆಲ್ವೇಸ್ ವಾಂಟ್ಸ್ ಟು ಬಿಕಮ್ ಸಮಥಿಂಗ್ ಸಮಥಿಂಗ್ ಬಿಕಮಿಂಗ್ ಎ ಪ್ಯೂರ್ ಈಗೋ ಬಿಕಮಿಂಗ್ ಎ ಪ್ಯೂರ್ ಈಗೋ ಸಾತ್ವಿಕ್ ಈಸ್ ದ ಪರ್ಪಸ್ ಸಾತ್ವಿಕ್ ಈಗೋ ಅಲ್ಲಿಗೆ ಇದು ಎಲ್ಲ ಟು ಮೇಕ್ ದಿ ಈಗೋ ಸಾತ್ವಿಕ್ ಫ್ರಮ್ ರಾಜಸಿಕ್ ತಮಸಿಕ್ ಟು ಮೇಕ್ ಸಾತ್ವಿಕ್ ದಟ್ ಇಸ್ ದ ಪರ್ಪಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಕರ್ಮಯೋಗ ಭಕ್ತಿಯೋಗ ಜ್ಞಾನಯೋಗ ಕ್ರಿಯಾಯೋಗ ಕ್ರಿಯಾಯೋಗ ರಿಟರ್ನ್ ರಿಟರ್ನ್ ಹಾಂ ನಾಲ್ಕು ಉದ್ದೇಶ ಸಾತ್ವಿಕ್ ಆಗಬರಬೇಕು ಪ್ಯೂರ್ ಸಾತ್ವಿಕ್ ಈಗೋ ಬರಬೇಕು ಓಕೆ ಎಂಡಿಂಗ್ ಆಫ್ ದಿ ಪ್ರೊಸೆಸ್ ಬೈ ಗೋಯಿಂಗ್ ಬಿಯಾಂಡ್ ಸಾತ್ವಿಕ್ ಈಗೋ ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ವಿಚಾರ ಮಾರ್ಗ ರೈಟ್ ಸೊ ದಿ ಪೀಪಲ್ ಹೂ ಪ್ರಾಕ್ಟೀಸ್ ಯೋಗ ಮಾರ್ಗ ದೇ ಆರ್ ಕಾಲ್ಡ್ ಕರ್ಮಯೋಗ ಯೋಗ ಮಾರ್ಗ ದೇ ಆರ್ ಕಾಲ್ಡ್ ಯೋಗೀಸ್ ಸಾಧಕ್ಸ್ ಸೊ ಐ ಡೋಂಟ್ ಗಿವ್ ದಮ್ ನೇಮ್ ಸಿದ್ಧಾಸ್ ವಿಚಾರ ಮಾರ್ಗ ಈಸ್ ನಾಟ್ ಎ ಪ್ರೊಸೆಸ್ ಲೀಡ್ಸ್ ಟು ಸಿದ್ಧಿ ಆರ್ ಜ್ಞಾನ ಆತ್ಮಜ್ಞಾನ ಆತ್ಮ ದರ್ಶನ ಆಕ್ಚುಲಿ ದಿ ಸಿದ್ಧಿ ವರ್ಡ್ ಇಸ್ ಯೂಸ್ ಬೈ ಪೀಪಲ್ ಕನ್ಫ್ಯೂಸಿಂಗ್ಲಿ ದ ವರ್ಡ್ ಇಟ್ಸೆಲ್ಫ್ ಇಸ್ ನಾಟ್ ಕನ್ಫ್ಯೂಸಿಂಗ್ ಓಕೆ ಐ ವಿಲ್ ಸೇ ರಿಯಲೈಸೇಷನ್ ಯಾ ಸೊ ಆಕ್ಚುಲಿ ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಯೋಗ ಮಾರ್ಗದಲ್ಲಿ ಓಕೆ ಯೋಗ ಮಾರ್ಗ ಇನ್ವಾಲ್ವ್ಸ್ ಸಿದ್ಧಿಸ್ ಇನ್ವಾಲ್ವ್ಸ್ ಸೂಪರ್ ನ್ಯಾಚುರಲ್ ಪವರ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ಎಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ರಾಡಿನರಿ ಪವರ್ಸ್ ಪವರ್ಸ್ ಓಕೆ ಸೊ ಫಾರ್ ಕರ್ಮಯೋಗ ಪರ್ಸನ್ ಒನ್ ಕರ್ಮಯೋಗ ಕರ್ಮಯೋಗ ಗೆಟ್ಸ್ ಕರ್ಮ ಸಿದ್ಧಿ ಓಕೆ ಹಿ ಬಿಕಮ್ ಸಕ್ಸಸ್ಫುಲ್ ಇನ್ ವಾಟ್ ಎವರ್ ಇಟ್ ಡಸ್ ದಿಸ್ ಕಾಲ್ಡ್ ಕರ್ಮ ಸಿದ್ಧಿ ಓಕೆ ಪರ್ಸನ್ ಒನ್ ಭಕ್ತಿಯೋಗ ಓಕೆ ಗೆಟ್ಸ್ ದಿ ಕ್ವಾಲಿಟೀಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಇಷ್ಟ ದೇವತಾ ದೇವತಾ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಸಮ್ ಪವರ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಇಷ್ಟ ದೇವತಾ ಹಾಂ ಪವರ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಇಷ್ಟ ದೇವತಾ ಸಮ್ ಪವರ್ಸ್ ಓಕೆ ಡೆಂಟ್ ಸೇ ಆಲ್ ಆಲ್ ದಿ ಪವರ್ಸ್ ದೀಸ್ ಆರ್ ಆಲ್ ಸಿದ್ಧಿಸ್ ಐ ಆಮ್ ಸ್ಪೀಕಿಂಗ್ ಬಿಕಾಸ್ ಯುವರ್ ಕ್ವಶನ್ ಇಸ್ ಅಬೌಟ್ ಸಿದ್ಧಿಸ್ ಐ ಆಮ್ ಟೆಲಿಂಗ್ ಓಕೆ ಸೊ ವೆನ್ ಐ ಸೇ ಕರ್ಮ ಸಿದ್ಧಿ Okay, people, whenever they do something, they become successful or failure. A person who adopts karma yoga, whatever he does, the chance of success is maximum. Okay, failure chances are less. He becomes very focused, clear in what he does. Okay, and person on bhakti yoga gets some ishta devata siddhi. That means somebody worships Lakshmi.
Yes.
Okay. So what happens is that there will be starting of money flow in his house. Understand? Same thing happens to people who worship Venkatramana. So these are called ishta devata. So that powers of the devata will flow through you. Okay. So people who adopt Kriya Yoga, okay, they get mental powers. Okay. They are actually 8. Anima, Garima, that. Okay. Ashta Siddhis. Some of them they get, not all. See, they are able to read minds of people. Okay. Which is the most useful thing to, useless thing to do. Reading your mind is more than enough for you. Already so much of junk is there.
Watching others junk.
Okay, so that's called Kriya Yoga Siddhi. Okay, and they are very fantastic. Okay, then Jnana Yoga Siddhi. Siddhi is clarity of thought, clarity of thinking. So, yenagutte, mind becomes uncluttered. Uncluttered mind. No confusions, clear. This is what is required in life. Uncluttered mind. Okay. Vichara marga, first it drops to all siddhis. Drop all siddhis, drop doership, drop enjoyership, become free from all nonsense. So, here, drop all doership, enjoyership, okay, and knowership. And associates with this. So Shiva says in Shiva Sutra, Yoga Marga Dal Hogori, you get most of the siddhis.
What asking? What is the greatness in dropping everything?
So
you're losing everything.
So what happens is that, okay, his question is, so what happens with dropping? Okay, so there is a man. Papa, ಅವನು ಯಾಕೆ ಸಿದ್ಧಿಗಳನ್ನು ಬಿಡಬೇಕು ಅಂತ ಕೇಳ್ತಾರೆ. ಯೋಗ ಮಾರ್ಗದಲ್ಲಿ ಹೋಗಿ ಎಲ್ಲ ಸಿದ್ಧಿ ಬರ್ತದೆ, ಯಾಕೆ ಬಿಡಬೇಕು ಅಂತ ಕೇಳ್ತಾರೆ. ಎಲ್ಲ ಸಿಕ್ಕಿದ್ದು ಯಾಕೆ ಬಿಡಬೇಕು ಅಂತ ಒಂದು ಲೆಕ್ಕ, ಕರೆಕ್ಟ್. ಸೊ ಒನ್ ಮ್ಯಾನ್, ಓಕೆ, ಒನ್ ಮ್ಯಾನ್, ಎ ಪೂರ್ ಮ್ಯಾನ್, ಒಬ್ಬ ಬಡವ. ಅವನು ಮಾಡ್ತಾನೆ, ಹೀ ಕೀಪ್ಸ್ ಆನ್ ಗೋಯಿಂಗ್ ಸರ್ಚಿಂಗ್ ಫಾರ್ ಸಮಥಿಂಗ್. ದೆನ್ ಹೀ ಮೀಟ್ಸ್ ಎ ಮಾಂಕ್, ಒಬ್ಬ ಸನ್ಯಾಸಿ ಇರ್ತಾನೆ. ಓಕೆ, ಹೀ ಮೀಟ್ಸ್ ಎ ಮಾಂಕ್. ಐ ಆಮ್ ಲುಕಿಂಗ್ ಫಾರ್ ಮನಿ, ಸೇಸ್, ನನಗೆ ದುಡ್ಡು ಬೇಕು ಅಂತ. Sanyasi monk says, that's all. You go 2 kilometers, there's a big tree, dig below. Okay? He goes there and digs. And he finds a pot full of silver coins. One bellia copper. He brings it, enjoys it, and his wife goes for shopping. In 3 days, it's over.
internet
rater. So, whatever money you have, just disappear in no time. You didn't earn actually, got.
Found.
So, again he goes to the monk. Puna Vaktane. Then he says, monk, go another 2 kilometers, you find another tree, find, dig there.
Why will monk give?
We'll find out. Why will monk give? Correct question.
There must
be some trick. So now he goes and digs there. There he finds a golden pot. Olle bangarada nidhi sikkide.
Only golden pot, no money.
No, gold with gold coins. So he brings that. How many days it lasts?
Five.
So now he has been able to spend 6 months. He keeps a little bit carefully.
Okay.
Six months.
Give it to his wife.
Okay. So after 6 months, again he goes to the monk. Now he has a doubt. Okay, there must be some trick in this monk. The monk cannot take money. Because he is able to show silver coins, golden coins, he must be sitting on diamonds. He says, please get up. Yedadappa, I want to dig what you are sitting on. Because if you have to give me silver and gold, you must be having much more. There must be much bigger thing.
He should know.
Okay.
Instead of that, he should ask, how do you know this?
No. The technology. So the monk says, okay, dig. So he digs, nothing is there. Yanilali. Then he says, you are able to give me this, all those things. You must be knowing some secret which I don't know. You know, secret
is
Gunendra. Okay? Right?
Of course.
What?
Of course. He's saying,
of course. Of course. So can you give me that? The monk says, I have only one secret. I am very peaceful.
Mm-hmm.
Okay? So, give me that peace. Then come sit.
So, on that dug part.
No, closed it. So, what happens is that we want some money, gold, silver in life. We'll use it. Okay? Beyond certain point of time, all of them will not satisfy us. We need peace.
Everything will get over.
Get over or used or whatever happens. Finally, you say, okay, enough. I want total peace. Then you come back to the Guru. So, peace is within you. Which is, the peace is like infinity. It cannot be...
Like, if you donate, you might feel happy, right?
No, you do that also. All those things you will do. Finally, still, the peace will be missing. Full peace. So, then he will come back to Jnana. Okay? Like that, these people have siddhis, powers. Their powers, they will use it for giving it to somebody, some helping somebody.
Mm-hmm.
After some time, they will give up. Enough. Let me go for peace. Okay. That's what I am saying, Vichara Marga.
But won't you find that peace without dropping?
No. So what happens is that the people, they actually, here it is, there are two people, okay? This sugar, sugar you keep in a bowl. Ants will come and
eat it.
How do the ant know? Some internet message is gone, is it? WhatsApp message is gone that sugar is here?
No smell, they smell it.
How do you know? They have internet or what?
One will go touch and then send messages. Sent on the floor.
Yeah.
So, what happens is that the more and more people come near the people who have siddhis. People get attracted to siddhis. Right? People get attracted to power. I want this, I want that. And the other way,
ego.
Something. They come to people with siddhis. Okay, the person with siddhis will become very, very popular very quickly. Tumba famous agutara. And people come to him for siddhis only. I want this. Okay, now he gets trapped in that circle. What is that? Now I am famous. I want to become more famous. Okay, he uses the power to become more famous. Then he gets trapped in that. The ego becomes bigger and bigger. That causes disturbance. Shanti over there. That's why Shiva said in the Shiva Sutra. Okay? In Yoga Marga, you'll get siddhis. And the moment you drop those siddhis, you'll become realized. Because siddhis also is an attraction. It's a bigger attraction.
You have a choice to drop, so it's good. Use
it and drop it. So you get it first. Our kid is very smart. He knows exactly what is the path. So, okay, then what happens? A spiritual person or realized person. The ultimate happiness or peace is not miracles. Miracles are temporary. It's a patchwork. The final realization, final miracle is peace, shanti. There is no bigger miracle than peace. So now people who come to a person with Siddha Purusha, they are coming for siddhis, not for peace. Okay?
But how can you call peace a miracle? It's possible.
Is it possible to be peaceful for anybody?
For some people. It is possible. Many people have done it. So is it a miracle?
Give me an example of people who have done it.
Vivekananda.
That's some people, not many people. How many Vivekanandas are there?
Many people except Vivekananda. Others.
The others are very few. And those are the people I am speaking of who have dropped all this and gone for finally peace. Okay? Understand? Now, he says, now the person who is peaceful, only people who are seeking peace will come. Yaar shanti and baisukona brother, those only will come. Okay? Not the people with miracles. Now, the people with miracles have already gone. They are not there. So those who the people who are seeking peace are seeking mukti. Mukti and peace are same. The liberation and mukti, shanti matu shanti matu mukti and redu vande bere alladu. Adike Bhagavanta helidan Bhagavad para shanti adigachati. He will attain the supreme peace.
People who are peaceful, they also have the siddhi powers, but they don't use.
No.
Is that right?
No.
They have dropped it.
They have dropped
it, but they have the powers, but they don't use
they
it.
Are not there. Who is they?
People.
Who is they?
But what happens is some miracles happen in the presence.
The miracles happen in the presence.
In the presence.
They That's are not using that. Powers.
Miracles happen.
How can that happen then?
Sun is there. A plant grows. Without sun, plant can grow?
No.
Similarly, for Jnani, in the presence of Jnani, miracles happen. Provided you have karmic impressions which are required to make it happen.
He is not doing it, it's happening by itself.
Sun is making plant grow?
Sun is just there, it's not
perfect. Like that at Jnani, but he shines. In his presence, miracles happen. He is not the doer. People say Jnani did it, but he didn't. He says, I didn't do. Okay? Jnani heltane, naan maadilla anta heltane. Because he is not a doer. He has already dropped doership also. Okay? So he is not a doer. The miracles happen in such a person's presence. And the greatest miracle which happens in such a person's presence is called peace, shanti. Okay? So now, the number of people who come are few. Because most of the people are in power, money, magic, health. So Jnani says, I can't do anything. It's like, I'm just there. Ramana Maharshi people came and asked Ramana Maharshi, the Second World War is going on. You find out who you are. That is the answer. Okay? So this is the difference between the Jnani. He can access powers, but he doesn't do that. He is just dropped all of them. Okay, that's called Jnani. Siddhis are gone now. But miracles happen in the presence of Jnani. That is because of the karmic impression coming in the person. The right karmic impression, which will elevate him to mukti, will come in the presence of Jnani. Jnani is sannidhali. There is something happens in front of Jnani. Okay, now Jnani didn't do it. But the person says, because of Guru, because of Jnani, that happened. That happened in the presence of Jnani because for him the faith in Jnani has to increase. Jnani maki nambiki chasthe. For that, a karmic seed has to be there, karmic impression has to be there, which will trigger that. So now that karmic impression which increases the faith in Jnani will trigger in the presence of Jnani. The seed will sprout. That's a miracle. Understood?
He triggers that it happens.
He is not there, he is Brahman. His presence triggers. Is that understood? So, now you understand the difference between these three people?
Yeah.
Okay. So now we will go to, now what happened these people when they go further? In a person, yoga marga, yoga marga, a person can become a saint. Saint. This we call Santa. One person in the yoga marga, bhakti marga, was greatest bhakta called Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Okay? Chaitanya Mahaprabhu was peak of bhakti. But finally he had to get jnana from a jnana guru for liberation. Okay? And another person who was a great bhakta was Namadev. Okay? Finally he had to get a jnana from jnana guru. So that's why finally vichara marga you have to come. That's called karana guru. So now this saint, people feel blessed. People feel blessed in the presence of saint. There's a blessing. Their presence is blessing. Okay?
There is no liberation without jnana. So, bhakti
purifies.
Leads you to get the jnana.
Bhakti purifies you and prepares you for jnana.
Prepares you and maybe creates a situation to get jnana.
Correct.
And that devotee also gets moksha.
Yes. Okay. I will tell you what is jnana and what is bhakti. That understanding itself has to be purified. Mm. That will take it later. Mm. Okay. People feel blessed in the presence of jnani. But saint may show them, teach them a path. Path of purification. Typically when I say saint, he has not reached the final destination of non-duality. Mm-hmm. He is somewhere in Salokya, Samipya, Sarupya. Mm-hmm. Okay? Typically, Salokya, Samipya, Sarupya. This is what I call as typically a saint. Okay, then somebody comes to vichara, finally comes to jnana. I'll say, they'll say jnana, but I'm saying vichara. He becomes mukta, jivan mukta. And many of them, these saints become gurus. The teachers. Okay? But they don't know the final destination. And vichara marga, finally they have to come through this path, vichara marga. Then what happens? Jivan mukta. In jivan mukta, there are two categories. One category, just withdraws from world and goes to Brahmanishta. Another category, teaches and becomes Sadguru. Teaches people to reach. Seekers to reach Jivan Mukti. Idanna Ramakrishna Paramahansa heltare. This Ramakrishna Paramahansa heltare adakke. Ramakrishna Paramahansa heltare. There are many people. Okay, they are going on garden. Is a big garden, big wall is there, dodda gode ide. Aa godeyalli aa kade enu gothagala, what is there outside, that's you don't know. Some people climb on the wall. Ok, ಕೆಲವರು ಹತ್ತಾರೆ. ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ದೆನ್ ದಿ ಸಿ ವಾಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಔಟ್ ಸೈಡ್ ದಟ್ ಸೈಡ್ ವಾಲ್ ವಾಲ್ ಓಕೆ. ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಇಸ್ ಈಸ್ ಬ್ಯೂಟಿಫುಲ್ ಗಾರ್ಡನ್, ಭಾಳ ಸುಂದರವಾದ ತೋಟ ಇದೆ. ಔಟ್ ಆಫ್ 10 people, 9 people ಜಂಪ್ ದರ್ ಎಂಜಾಯ್ ದಿ ಫ್ರೂಟ್ಸ್, ಖುಷಿಯಾಗೋಗಿ ತಿಂತಾರೆ, ವಾಪಸ್ ಬರಲ್ಲ. ದೇ ಕಾಂಟ್ ದೇ ಡೋಂಟ್ ಕ್ಲೈಮ್ ಕ್ಲೈಮ್ ಬ್ಯಾಕ್. ಒನ್ ಪರ್ಸನ್ ವಿಲ್ ನಾಟ್ ಜಂಪ್ ಓಕೆ, ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಹೀ ಕಾಲ್ಸ್ ಅದರ್ ಪೀಪಲ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಮೇಕ್ಸ್ ಪೀಪಲ್ ಜಂಪ್, ಬಟ್ ಹೀ ವಿಲ್ ವೇಟ್ ಆಲ್ ದಿ ವೆನ್ ದ ಆಲ್ ಅದರ್ ಪೀಪಲ್ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಜಂಪ್ಡ್. ಸಚ್ ಎ ಪರ್ಸನ್ ಈಸ್ ಕಾಲ್ಡ್ ಸದ್ಗುರು. ಹೀ ಪೋಸ್ಟ್ಪೋನ್ಸ್ ಈಸ್ ಲಿಬರೇಷನ್ ಫಾರ್ ದಿ ಸೇಕ್ ಆಫ್
ಅದರ್ಸ್.
ನಾಟ್ ಫೈನಲ್ ಲಿಬರೇಷನ್, ಇಟ್ಸ್ ಕಾಲ್ಡ್ ವಿಧೇಯ ಮುಕ್ತಿ. ಐ ಫೈನ್ ಟೆಲ್ ಯು ವಾಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಇಟ್ ಓಕೆ. ಸೊ ನೌ ಹೂ ಇಸ್ ದಕ್ಷಿಣಾಮೂರ್ತಿ? ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಕ್ವಶನ್, ಐ ಸ್ಟಾರ್ಟ್ ದಿಸ್ ಫಾರ್ ದಕ್ಷಿಣಾಮೂರ್ತಿ. ನಿಮ್ಮ ಪ್ರಶ್ನೆ ಏನಂದ್ರೆ ದಕ್ಷಿಣಾಮೂರ್ತಿ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಯಾರು ಅಂತ. ಎನಿ ಸ್ಟೋರಿ ಆಫ್ ಸ್ಪಿರಿಚುವಲ್, ಎನಿ ಸ್ಟೋರಿ ಇನ್ ಪುರಾಣ, ಯು ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಟು ಗಿವ್ 3 levels ಆಫ್ ಮೀನಿಂಗ್. ಮೂರು ರೀತಿಯ ಅರ್ಥಗಳಿದ್ದಾವೆ, ಆದಿಭೌತಿಕ, ಆದಿದೈವಿಕ, ಆಧ್ಯಾತ್ಮಿಕ. ಮೂರು ರೀತಿಯ ಅರ್ಥಗಳು ಬರ್ತವೆ ಒಂದು ಕಥೆ, ಒಂದು ಯಾವುದೇ ಒಂದು ಕಥೆಗೆ ಓಕೆ. ನಾವೇನು ಮಾಡ್ತೇವೆ, ವಿ ಲಿಸನ್ ಟು ಸ್ಟೋರಿ ಓನ್ಲಿ ಅಟ್ ದಿ ಸರ್ಫೇಸ್ ಲೆವೆಲ್, ದಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಡೀಪರ್ ಲೆವೆಲ್ ಮೀನಿಂಗ್ ಇನ್ವಾಲ್ವ್ಡ್. ಸೊ ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ದ ಬ್ಯೂಟಿ ಆಫ್ ಇಂಡಿಯನ್ ಸ್ಕ್ರಿಪ್ಚರ್ಸ್, ಪುರಾಣಗಳು. ಏನೇ ಕಥೆಗೆ ಮೂರು ರೀತಿಯ ಅರ್ಥಗಳಿದೆ. ಫಾರ್ ಎಕ್ಸಾಂಪಲ್, ಲೆಟ್ ಮಿ ಆಸ್ಕ್ ಯು, ವಾಸ್ ದೇರ್ ಸಂಬಡಿ ಕಾಲ್ ಶ್ರೀಕೃಷ್ಣ? ವೇರ್? ಹೀ ಲಿವ್ಡ್ ಇನ್ ದ್ವಾರಕಾ 5053 years ಬ್ಯಾಕ್. ಶ್ರೀಕೃಷ್ಣ ಅಂತ ಒಬ್ಬಿದ್ದ ಒಂದು 5050 ವರ್ಷಗಳ ಹಿಂದೆ
ಹಿಸ್ಟ್ರಿ.
ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಕಾಲ್ಡ್ ಆದಿ ಭೌತಿಕ ಅಟ್ ದ ಫಿಸಿಕಲ್ ಲೆವೆಲ್ ಓಕೆ ರೈಟ್. ನಾವು ಫಾರ್ ಹೂಮ್ ಇಟ್ಸ್ ಇಂಪಾರ್ಟೆಂಟ್? ಫಾರ್ ಹಿಸ್ಟೋರಿಯನ್ಸ್, ಫಾರ್ ಆರ್ಕಿಯೋಲಜಿಸ್ಟ್, ವೆರಿ ಇಂಪಾರ್ಟೆಂಟ್. ಶ್ರೀಕೃಷ್ಣ ಲಿವ್ಡ್ ಇನ್ ದ್ವಾರಕಾ ದಿಸ್ ಪಾಯಿಂಟ್ ಆಫ್ ಟೈಮ್, ದಟ್ಸ್ ಕಾಲ್ಡ್ ಆದಿ ಭೌತಿಕ ಅರ್ಥ. ದೆನ್ ಕಮ್ಸ್ ಆಧ್ಯಾತ್ಮಿಕ, ಆದಿ ದೈವಿಕ ಓಕೆ. ಆದಿ ದೈವಿಕ ಹೂ ಇಸ್ ಶ್ರೀಕೃಷ್ಣ? ಶ್ರೀಕೃಷ್ಣ ಇಸ್ ಅವತಾರ ಮಹಾವಿಷ್ಣು, ಡಿವೋಷನ್ ಭಕ್ತ. ಫಾರ್ ಭಕ್ತ ಶ್ರೀಕೃಷ್ಣ ಇಸ್ ಅವತಾರ ಆಫ್ ವಿಷ್ಣು.
ಈಸ್ ಎ ಪರ್ಸ್ ಪರ್ಸನ್,
ದೇ ಫೈಂಡ್ ಔಟ್ ಪ್ಯಾಲೇಸ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಆಲ್ ದಿಸ್. ಸೊ ಫಾರ್ ಎ ಜ್ಞಾನಿ ಆಧ್ಯಾತ್ಮಿಕ ಅರ್ಥ ಇಸ್ ಇಂಪಾರ್ಟೆಂಟ್. ನನಗೆ ಏನು ಬೇಕು? ಸ್ಪಿರಿಚುವಲ್ ಮೀನಿಂಗ್. ಶ್ರೀಕೃಷ್ಣ ಈಸ್ ಮೈ ಆತ್ಮ, ಮೈ ಸೆಲ್ಫ್, ನನ್ನ ಆತ್ಮವೇ ಶ್ರೀಕೃಷ್ಣ ಓಕೆ. ಆದಿ ಭೌತಿಕ, ಆದಿ ದೈವಿಕ, ಆಧ್ಯಾತ್ಮಿಕ, ಮೂರು ರೀತಿಯ ಅರ್ಥಗಳು. ಕ್ಲಿಯರ್? ಆದಿ ಭೌತಿಕ ಇಸ್ ಯೂಸ್ಫುಲ್ ಫಾರ್ ಹಿಸ್ಟೋರಿಯನ್ಸ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಪೊಲಿಟಿಷಿಯನ್ಸ್, ಬಿಕಾಸ್ ಪೊಲಿಟಿಷಿಯನ್ಸ್ ಓ ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ಗ್ರೇಟ್ ಕಿಂಗ್ಡಮ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಆಲ್. ಆದಿ ದೈವಿಕ ಇಸ್ ಇಂಪಾರ್ಟೆಂಟ್ ಫಾರ್ ಭಕ್ತಾಸ್, ಆಧ್ಯಾತ್ಮಿಕ ಇಸ್ ಫಾರ್ ಜ್ಞಾನೀಸ್. ಫಾರ್ ಆಧ್ಯಾತ್ಮಿಕ ಕೃಷ್ಣ ಇಸ್ ಮೈ ಆತ್ಮ, ನನ್ನ ಆತ್ಮ, ಮೈ ಸೆಲ್ಫ್, ಮೈ ವಿಲ್ ಓಕೆ. ಸೊ 3 meanings ಆರ್ ದೇರ್ ಫಾರ್ ಎನಿ ಸ್ಟೋರಿ. ಸೊ ನೌ ಐ ವಿಲ್ ಟೆಲ್ ಯು ದಿ ಸ್ಟೋರಿ ಆಫ್ ರಮಣ ಮಹರ್ಷಿ ಟೋಲ್ಡ್. ರಮಣ ಮಹರ್ಷಿ ಏನು ಹೇಳಿದ್ರು, ಅವರಿಗೊಂದು ವಿಷನ್ ಆಯಿತು. ವಿಷನ್ ಅಂದರೆ ಇಟ್ಸ್ ಎ ವಿಷನ್ ಈಸ್ ಮೋರ್ ದೆನ್ ಡ್ರೀಮ್. ಲಿಸನ್ ಫುಲ್ಲಿ. ರಮಣ ಮಹರ್ಷಿಗೆ ಒಂದು ಕಾಣ್ತು ವಿಷನ್ ಏನಂದರೆ, ಒಂದು ಮರ ಇದೆ ಎಲ್ಲಿ ಅರುಣಾಚಲದಲ್ಲಿ, ಆ ಮರದ ಕೆಳಗೆ ಒಬ್ಬರು ಕೂತ್ಕೊಂಡಿದ್ದಾರೆ. ಒನ್ ಪರ್ಸನ್ ಇಸ್ ಸಿಟಿಂಗ್ ಬಿಲೋ ದ ಟ್ರೀ. ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ರಮಣ ಮಹರ್ಷಿ ಟ್ರೈಸ್ ಟು ಗೋ ನಿಯರ್ ದ್ಯಾಟ್, ದೆನ್ ಇದು ಬೀಸ್, ಹನಿ ಬೀಸ್ ಕಮ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಸ್ಟಿಂಗ್ ಹಿಮ್, ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಹಿ ವಾಸ್ ನಾಟ್ ಏಬಲ್ ಟು ಗೋ ದ್ಯಾರ್ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳಿದರು ಎಲ್ಲಿ ವಿಷನ್ನಲ್ಲಿ. ಇಟ್ಸ್ ಎ ವಿಷನ್ ಓಕೆ. ವಿಷನ್ ಈಸ್ ಡಿಫ್ರೆಂಟ್ ಫ್ರಮ್ ಪ್ರತ್ಯಕ್ಷ ಓಕೆ. ದೆನ್ ಮೆನಿ ಡಿವೋಟೀಸ್ ವಾಂಟೆಡ್ ಟು ಗೋ ದ್ಯಾರ್ ಟು ಫೈಂಡ್ ಔಟ್ ಎದರ್ ದ ಟ್ರೀ ಇಸ್ ದ್ಯಾರ್ ಆರ್ ನಾಟ್, ಆ ಮರ ಇದೆ ಅಂತ ಬಳಿಕೆ. ರಮಣ ಮಹರ್ಷಿ ಸೇಡ್ ಡೋಂಟ್ ಗೋ ದ್ಯಾರ್, ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ನಾಟ್ material, it's a spiritual tree. ఇదో ఫిజికల్ అల్ల, ఆది భౌతిక అల్ల, ఇట్స్ ఎ స్పిరిచువల్ అంత హేదు. సో నౌ పీపుల్ స్టార్ట్ థింకింగ్ దట్ దర్ ఇస్ ఎ ట్రీ దెన్ అండ్ ది పర్సన్ సిట్టింగ్ బిలో దెన్ ఇస్ కాల్డ్ దక్షిణామూర్తి. ఓకే, సో పీపుల్ విల్ గో దెన్. నౌ దట్ స్టోరీ ఈస్ అప్లికేబుల్ టు పీపుల్ హు ఆర్ ఇన్ ది ఆది భౌతిక ద ఫిజికల్ దెన్ బికాస్ దట్స్ ఎ ఫిజికలీ పర్సన్ షుడ్ బి సిట్టింగ్ దెన్. ఓకే, there should be a person who is physically sitting there is called Dakshinamurti for people who are very grossly identified with the body. Nanu deha antu tilkodage Dakshinamurti anta avaru kutkondidare. Nanu kannada helidna, kannada miss maadkonda, nanu edo helidu English hoyta. Okay, so Ramana Maharshi helige ondu kanasu vittu kaantu, yen kaantu, ondu mara ide, aa marada kelige obba kutkondidane yogi, chana kaanta idane. ಆ ಮರದಂದ್ರೆ ಎಲ್ಲ ಹೋಗ್ಲಿಕ್ಕೆ ಪ್ರಯತ್ನ ಮಾಡ್ರು ಯಾರು ರಮಣ ಮಹರ್ಷಿಗಳು. ಹೋದಾಗ ಎಲ್ಲ ಇದು ಕಚ್ಕೃತವಾಗಿ ಜೇನು ಕಚ್ಚಿದ ಕೂಡ ವಾಪಸ್ ಬಂದ್ಬಿಟ್ರು ಅವರು ಅಂತ ಹೇಳಿದರು. ಆಗ ಯಾರಿಗೆ ಶಿಷ್ಯರು ಹೇಳಿದರು, ಶಿಷ್ಯರೆಲ್ಲ ಹುಡ್ಕೊಂಡು ಹೋಗ್ಲಿಕ್ಕೆ ಶುರು ಮಾಡಿದೆ ಮರ. ಆಗ ರಮಣ ಮಹರ್ಷಿಗಳ ಮರ ಹುಡ್ಕೊಂಡು ಹೋಗ್ಬಿಡಿಯಪ್ಪ, ಅದು ಭೌತಿಕ ಅಲ್ಲ, ಅದು ಆಧ್ಯಾತ್ಮಿಕ ಸ್ಪಿರಿಚುವಲ್ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳಿದರು. ಜನರಿಗೆ ಅರ್ಥ ಆಗಿಲ್ಲ. ಅದು ಪ್ರತಿಯೊಂದು ಕಥೆಗೂ ಮೂರು ಅರ್ಥ ಇದೆ, ಆದಿ ಭೌತಿಕ, ಆದಿ ದೈವಿಕ, ಆಧ್ಯಾತ್ಮಿಕ. ಶ್ರೀರಾಮ ಇದ್ನೋ ಖಂಡಿತ ಇದ್ದ ಅಯೋಧ್ಯೆಯಲ್ಲಿ ಎಷ್ಟು 10,000 ವರ್ಷದಿಂದ. ಅದು ಆದಿ ಭೌತಿಕ. ಅದು ಯಾರಿಗೆ ಇಂಪಾರ್ಟೆಂಟು, ಫಾರ್ ಹೂಮ್ ಇಸ್ ಇಂಪಾರ್ಟೆಂಟ್? ಹಿಸ್ಟೋರಿಯನ್ಸ್ಗೆ, ಪೊಲಿಟಿಷಿಯನ್ಸ್ಗೆ. ಶ್ರೀರಾಮ ವಿಷ್ಣುವಿನ ಅವತಾರ, ಅದು ಯಾರಿಗೆ ಇಂಪಾರ್ಟೆಂಟು? ಭಕ್ತರಿಗೆ. ಶ್ರೀರಾಮ ನನ್ನ ಆತ್ಮ ರಾಮ, ಅದು ಯಾರಿಗೆ ಇಂಪಾರ್ಟೆಂಟು? ಜ್ಞಾನ ಮಾರ್ಗದಲ್ಲಿ. ಆಯ್ತಾ, ಪ್ರಶ್ನೆ ಏನಂದ್ರೆ ನಿಮ್ಗೆ ಯಾವ ಮಾರ್ಗದಲ್ಲಿ ನಿಮ್ಗೆ ಎಲ್ಲಿ ಬೇಕೋ ಅದೇ ಅದೇ ಸಿಗೋದು ನಿಮಗೆ, ಬೇರೆ ಸಿಗಲ್ಲ. ಆಯ್ತಾ, ನಮ್ಮ ಕನ್ಫ್ಯೂಷನ್ ಯಾವಾಗುತ್ತೆ, ನಾವು ಯಾವ್ದು ಮಾಡಿದ್ರೆ ಒಂದು ಏನೋ ಹುಡ್ಕೊಂಡು ಹೋಗ್ತೇವೆ, ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಕನ್ಫ್ಯೂಷನ್ ಆಗೋದು. ನೀವೆಲ್ಲಿದ್ದೀರಪ್ಪ? ಹುಡುಕ್ತಾ ಇದ್ದೀರಿ, ಏನಂದ ಕಳೆದೋದ್ ಯಾರು? ರೈಟ್. ಆಯ್ತಾ, ದೇರ್ ಆರ್ ತ್ರೀ ವೇಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಇಂಟರ್ಪ್ರಿಟಿಂಗ್ ಸ್ಟೋರಿ. ಇಲ್ಲಿ ರಮಣ ಮಹರ್ಷಿಗಳು ಹೇಳಿದ ಕಥೆಯ ಅರ್ಥ ಏನು ಅಂತ. ಓಕೆ, ಆದಿ ಭೌತಿಕ ಕಥೆಯ ಅರ್ಥ, ಆದಿ ಭೌತಿಕ ಅಂದರೆ ಫಿಸಿಕಲ್. ಒಂದಾನೊಂದು ಕಾಲದಲ್ಲಿ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಒಬ್ಬ ಯೋಗಿ ಬಂದು ಧ್ಯಾನಕ್ಕೆ ಕೂತ್ಕೊಂಡಿದ್ರು. ಅವರು ಅವರ ಹೆಸರು ದಕ್ಷಿಣಾಮೂರ್ತಿ ಅಂತ. ಒಂದಾನೊಂದು ಕಾಲದಲ್ಲಿ ಅಂದರೆ ಒನ್ಸ್ ಅಪಾನ್ ಟೈಮ್, ಅದು ಕಾಲದಲ್ಲಿ ಆದಿ ಭೌತಿಕ. ಆಯಿತಾ, ಅದು ಆಧ್ಯಾತ್ಮಿಕ ಅರ್ಥ ಅಂದರೆ ಆ ದಕ್ಷಿಣಾಮೂರ್ತಿ ಯಾರು ಅಲ್ಲ, ಶಿವನೇ. ಅದು ಆಧ್ಯಾತ್ಮಿಕ ಅರ್ಥ. ಆದಿ ದೈವಿಕ ಅರ್ಥ ಏನಂದರೆ ದಕ್ಷಿಣಾಮೂರ್ತಿ ಅಂದರೆ ನನ್ನ ಆತ್ಮ ಅಂತ. ಆದಿ ದೈವಿಕ ಶಿವ, ಆಧ್ಯಾತ್ಮಿಕ ಅಂದರೆ ನನ್ನ ಆತ್ಮ. ದರ್ ತ್ರೀ ಮೀನಿಂಗ್ಸ್ ಟು ಟೋಲ್ಡ್ ಸ್ಟೋರಿ ಟೋಲ್ಡ್ ರಮಣ ಮಹರ್ಷಿ. ಆದಿ ಭೌತಿಕ ಮೀನ್ಸ್ ಒನ್ಸ್ ಅಪಾನ್ ಎ ಟೈಮ್ ಒನ್ ಯೋಗಿ ಕೇಮ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಮೆಡಿಟೇಟ್ ದ್ಯಾಟ್ ಒನ್ಸ್ ಅಪಾನ್ ಎ ಟೈಮ್, ಮೇ ಬಿ 1,000 ಇಯರ್ಸ್, ಮೇ ಬಿ 10,000 ಇಯರ್ಸ್. ದಟ್ ಯೋಗಿ ಈಸ್ ಕಾಲ್ಡ್ ದಕ್ಷಿಣಾಮೂರ್ತಿ. ಓಕೆ, ಸೊ ದಿಸ್ ಕಾ ಆದಿ ಭೌತಿಕ. ಆದಿ ದೈವಿಕ ಮೀನ್ಸ್ ದಟ್ ದಕ್ಷಿಣಾಮೂರ್ತಿ ಇಸ್ ನಥಿಂಗ್ ನೋ ನನ್ ಅದರ್ ದನ್ ಶಿವ. ಆಧ್ಯಾತ್ಮಿಕ ಮೀನ್ಸ್ ದಕ್ಷಿಣಾಮೂರ್ತಿ ಈಸ್ ಮೈ ಸೆಲ್ಫ್, ನನ್ನ ಆತ್ಮ. ಅದು ನನ್ನ ಆತ್ಮ ಹೇಗಂತ ನಾನು ಎಕ್ಸ್ಪ್ಲೇನ್ ಮಾಡ್ತೇನೆ ನಿಮಗೆ. ಓಕೆ, ಐ ವಿಲ್ ಗಿವ್ ಓನ್ಲಿ ದಿ ಥರ್ಡ್ ಮೀನಿಂಗ್, ನಾಟ್ ದಿ ಫಸ್ಟ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಸೆಕೆಂಡ್. ಫಸ್ಟ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಸೆಕೆಂಡ್ ಮೀನಿಂಗ್ ಇಸ್ ನಾಟ್ ಇಂಪಾರ್ಟೆಂಟ್ ಫಾರ್ ಮೀ. ಮೊದಲನೇ ಎರಡು ನನಗೆ ಇಂಪಾರ್ಟೆಂಟ್ ಅಲ್ಲ. ಕ್ಲಿಯರ್? ಸೊ ದಿಸ್ ಕಮ್ಸ್ ಫ್ರಮ್, ದಿಸ್ ಮೀನಿಂಗ್ ಕಮ್ಸ್ ಫ್ರಮ್ ಮುಂಡಕ ಉಪನಿಷತ್. ಮುಂಡಕ ಉಪನಿಷತ್ತಲ್ಲಿ ದೇರ್ ಆರ್ ಟೂ ಬೀಯಿಂಗ್ಸ್. ಓಕೆ, ಟೂ ಬರ್ಡ್ಸ್, ಎರಡು ಹಕ್ಕಿಗಳಿದ್ದಾವೆ. ಒಂದು ಹಕ್ಕಿ ಹಣ್ಣು ತಿಂತಾ ಇದೆ, ದುಃಖ ಪಡ್ತಾ ಇದೆ, ಇನ್ನೊಂದು ಹಕ್ಕಿ ಅದನ್ನು ನೋಡ್ತಾ ಇದೆ. ದ್ವಾ ಸುಪರ್ಣ ಸಹಜ ಸಕಾಯಂ, ಎರಡು ಹಕ್ಕಿಗಳು ಮರದ ಮೇಲೆ ಕೂತ್ಕೊಂಡು ತಿಂತಾ ಇದೆ. ಒಂದು ಹಕ್ಕಿ ತಿಂತಾ ಇದೆ, ಇನ್ನೊಂದು ಹಕ್ಕಿ ನೋಡ್ತಾ ಇದೆ. ಒನ್ ಬರ್ಡ್ ಈಸ್ ಈಟಿಂಗ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಅದರ್ ಬರ್ಡ್ ಈಸ್ ಸೀಯಿಂಗ್. ದ ಟ್ರೀ ಈಸ್ ಕಾಲ್ಡ್ ಮಾಯ, ಸಂಸಾರ. ದ ಟ್ರೀ ಈಸ್ ಕಾಲ್ಡ್ ಸಂಸಾರ, ದ ವರ್ಲ್ಡ್ ಅಪಿಯರ್ಸ್. ದ ರೂಟ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಟ್ರೀ ಈಸ್ ಹೆವನ್ಸ್, ಬ್ರಹ್ಮನ್. ಒನ್ ಬರ್ಡ್ ಈಸ್ ಕಾಲ್ಡ್ ಜೀವ ಅಂಡ್ ಅದರ್ ಬರ್ಡ್ ಈಸ್ ಕಾಲ್ಡ್ ಆತ್ಮ. ಓಕೆ, ದಿ ಆತ್ಮ ಇನ್ ರಿಯಾಲಿಟಿ ಈಸ್ ಕಾಲ್ಡ್ ದಕ್ಷಿಣಾಮೂರ್ತಿ. ಓಕೆ, ಬಿಕಾಸ್ ಆತ್ಮ ಈಸ್ ಗುರು, ಆತ್ಮವೇ ಗುರು. ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಗುರು ಶಿವ ಇಸ್ ದಿ ಆದಿ ಗುರು. Atma destroys all ignorance. That's why Atma is the Adi Guru, the final Guru. So Dakshinamurti is in us as Atma, the first meaning. Okay, he is the one who is watching Sakshi. Sakshi ayi northa idare. Okay, and the bird which is coming, bird which is watching is Jiva. Okay, the bird is Jiva. So now the Jiva.
Yadu? One
Atma.
The one which is seeing is Atma.
Sakshi. Atma.
The one which is eating is
Jiva. The Sakshi is called Dakshinamurti because Jiva, Jiva idalla, is suffering. Okay? And he goes from birth to death he goes on going. Birth to death, huttu savagala hogta irthane. In ancestors language, death is Dakshina. Death is called Dakshina Dikku. Yavagale, hindina kaladalli. Ancestors told, the death is Dakshina. Okay? The bird is moving towards Dakshina, death. And one who is watching Sakshi is also looking at Dakshina. One who is suffering. Got it? Sakshi is looking at the bird. That means which direction is looking? Dakshina. Dakshina Dikkan Nodta Adhan, Dakshina Murthy. Adhe Sakshi. Right?
Sakshi is looking at a bird which is facing death.
Which is facing death. That's why it's called Dakshinamurti. Are we clear? Atmame Dakshinamurti. The Atma is called Dakshinamurti. Now you want to take a Adi Bhautika meaning, Adi Daivika meaning, Dakshinamurti is Shiva for puja purpose, for worshipping purpose. Otherwise, as per Veda, as per teachings of Rishis, Dakshinamurti is your Atma. Okay?
Then you said that he had a vision that he was sitting below a tree. What does that tree represent?
Tree, I told you, no? Maya, samsara. Samsara Vraksha. Are you clear? Dakshinamurti is called Atma. Adhyatmika Artha. Then Mara is samsara. And why he is facing towards Dakshina? Because the Jiva is going to Dakshina, dying. Uttada Saitade, suffering. That's why he has to look at Dakshina. Aita? Sakshi yalli unnod bulmate. Sakshi yalla kan nodate. But then he watches this bird suffering. That's called Dakshinamurti.
And
okay?
Why couldn't Ravana Maharshi go near?
So, next question, next is, Dakshinamurti always teaches in silence. Atma is Nirvikalpa Nirakara. Nirvikalpa means no thought. Who else can teach in silence other than Dakshinamurti?
Nature.
No. Self. Atma. So, Dakshinamurti is a teacher in silence. And in symbolism of Dakshinamurti, Dakshinamurti nodu aganiyo, marad kelagal naalku ella jana kutkondirtara old mudukuru alva huduga young, Dakshinamurti young and students are old bahuna jarmanamante nanavan maam prapadyade. How many years old are you, sir?
21.
Are you?
Not yet.
How many years?
18 years.
I asked you the...
So but if you take the point of view of the world, I'm 81.
What point?
Otherwise, I'm birthless and deathless.
That's the old man which is sitting near Dakshinamurti. Jiva. Okay, Jiva, after many lifetimes, he is considered as old. Michu. Understood. So the students are old, the teacher is young. Atma never becomes old, that's why he is young. And the students are old because they have matured to many lifetimes, they have become old.
Yeah.
Okay? Artha aita? Adan naan Shivan rupada helabodu, Dakshinamurti. Dakshinamurti bandage ella rushigalu bandru ella mudukuru anta helabodu. That's for adhyatmika artha. But real meaning is adhyatmika. For the ancient one, the Atma, which has no birth, no death, no aging, he is a young boy, Dakshinamurti, sitting below a tree called
Maya.
Atma. and he teaches in silence. He is radiating silence and peace. And the students come to him for their jiva. And he is looking at Dakshina, he is looking at south, because south is the direction of death. The jiva is always going towards the death, running away to running to death. He is looking at that fellow, poor fellow, come. And he is teaching, he is in silence. And that is the reason Ramana Maharshi told, it is not a physical tree, it is a spiritual tree. Ramana Maharshi explained his understanding of Dakshinamurti in the form of story, and student misunderstood it. He told, that's why, don't worry, it's a spiritual tree. See how people can convert reality into false. Now if you also go to this thing, Tiruvannamalai, people say there is a tree where Dakshinamurti is sitting. Go, you will also search it. It is not a physical tree, it is a mythological tree. Mythological means it's a Adi Daivika. Where Shiva comes and sits, that's perfectly alright. It is actually Adhyatmika tree. That tree you have to search inside. Okay? Arunachala. Okay? Arunachala. Aruna means rays of sun. Suryana Belaku. Achala means non-moving. What doesn't move is Achala. Arunachala means non-moving rays. What is that called? Adhyanadu?
How is that possible?
How is that possible,
sir? Light moves.
No. It's radiating. It's always there. That is called Atma Jyoti. Non-moving light of the self is called Arunachala. Okay? So now, Adi Kathiyal Enthara, Ramana Marjvidi, Dakshinamurti. Ramana is who? Ramana is Atma. Now what else you want? Clear? I will tell you Adi Bhautikartha also. Okay? This is spiritual meaning of the story. And this is the only meaning which Ramana Maharshi communicated. People misunderstood it, that's why he said, don't worry about that. That's why not a physical tree. Okay? Till today, if you go there, people will say there is a tree and some Daksha, this thing. Because people only think in terms of bodies. Correctly? So now let us go to next level of understanding. It comes to Adi Bhautika, physical level. Every teacher who is realized is Dakshinamurti, because he has realized Shiva in him. Okay? If he has not realized Shiva in him, he cannot be a guru, Sadguru. He has become Shiva Swarupi. That's why Shiva always comes in the form of Sadguru as Dakshinamurti. You think Dakshinamurti comes once in a while? Some time pass and goes? He has been coming ages. Only for the seekers of peace. Yari Shanti Beko, our Dakshinamurti Rupadali, Sadguru Agi Bhartare. That is Shiva. Okay. Understand? And the teaching is of two types. Teaching is of three types for Shiva. Murritya teaching. The students are of three types. Murritya Vidyatigal. Uttamadhikari, Madhyamadhikari, Vattu, Adamadhikari. Higher level, middle level and lower level. So this Shiva calls in Shiva Sutra, it's called Beda, 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 Abeda. There are three types of students. Beda means they are so body conscious, they feel only difference. Beda. Okay? Andre, they are so ingrained in the body that they don't even know Atma. That's called Beda. So Beda Beda means people have started thinking that, oh, God is in me. Abheda means those who are seeking oneness with God, oneness with Shiva. Beda, 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 Abheda. Okay. So Beda, for those people with Beda, Shiva teaches worship. Puja Madhana Hirpurthare. Okay. This is what is Agama Shastra say about temple, worship and all. This is for the people who are in the deepest level of Beda, Beda Bhava, first level. That's why, because of the Agama Shastra, all these temples have come. Okay? First level of teaching is through temples. Puja, rituals, that's the first level of puji. Stotra, mantra, japa, this is called Beda, first level of teaching. Arthagdhya? So now, some people graduate from that. Okay. And this method of teaching is called Anupaya. Anupaya.
Anupaya.
I am telling all quoting from Shiva. Shiva's teaching.
Anupaya.
Anupaya. Anu means that person is feels he is small. Then next level of teaching is called for people who want to go graduate from temple worship to meditation and breathing practices, pranayama, yoga.
Beda.
So they are called Beda Beda. For them, Shiva taught yoga. Yama, niyama, asana, pranayama, pratyahara, dhana, dharana, samadhi. Shiva taught. That's why he is Yogeshwara. Okay? So that's called Shaktopaya. You are focusing on Shakti now, rather than worship. Okay? Then finally, who comes for Jnana? The realization. They are called?
Abheda.
Huh? Abheda. No, Abheda. Mm-hmm. Now they are seeking for merger. Mm-hmm. Okay? That's called Shambhavopaya. Shambhava means Shiva. Shambhavopaya. For them, Shiva teaches Nididhyasa. Sit silently. Understood? So there are three margas for depending on three sadhana.
Shambhavopaya, Shambhavi Vidya are different.
Shambhavopaya, Shambhavi Vidya bagi namaku gotilla. It's called Shambhavopaya. I don't, if you understand what Shambhavi Vidya, I'll tell you. But it's called Shambhav. I don't know, it may be same as told as Shambhavi.
Something like that only. It's quiet and going into silence.
Okay, must be there. Because Shiva tells this, what I'm telling you, Shiva tells to Parvati. So that whatever Shiva has told to Parvati, I'm telling you people. Shiva Parvati hedidana, nimge heltidare. It's called Shambhavopaya. Okay, Shambhavopaya is Nididhyasa. Nididhyasa is Shambhavopaya. That means total surrender. In Shaktopaya, Anupaya, there is a doership. I do this, I do this, I do the puja, I do the mantra, I do the japa. I go to yatra, I chant, nana adu martene, dhyana martene, puja martene, adella Shambhavopaya. Devasthana kogudu, madalane upaya, Shiva helpadudu. Adu, yaro jeevigalu, Bhagavanta bere, nanu bere anta yochana martidare, avarige, Anupaya anta. ಯಾರ ಜೀವಿಗಳು ಭಗವಂತನ ಹತ್ರ ಇದ್ದಾನೆ ಅಂತ ಯೋಚನೆ ಮಾಡ್ತಾರೆ ಅವರಿಗೆ ಪ್ರಾಣಾಯಾಮ ನಿಧಿ ಧ್ಯಾನ ಯೋಗ ಯಮ ನಿಯಮ ಆಸನ ಪ್ರಾಣಾಯಾಮ ಪ್ರತ್ಯಾಹಾರ ಧಾನ ಧಾರಣ ಸಮಾಧಿ ಇಟ್ಸ್ ಕಾಲ್ಡ್ ಶಕ್ತೋಪಾಯ ಇಲ್ಲ ಭಗವಂತ ಮತ್ತು ನಾನು ಒಂದಾಗಬೇಕು ನಾನು ಒಂದೇ ಇದ್ದೇನೆ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳ್ತೀವಿ ಯಾರು ತಿಂಗ್ ಮಾಡ್ತಾರೆ ಅದಕ್ಕೆ ಭೇದ ಅಭೇದ ಅಸ್ಕ ಅದ್ವೈತ ಓಕೆ ಅವರಿಗೆ ಅಣು ಶಾಂಭೋಪಾಯ ಅಂತ ಅವರಿಗೆ ನಿಧಿತ್ಯಾಸ ಹೇಗೆ ಮಾಡೋದು ಅದನ್ನು ಹೇಳಿಕೊಟ್ಟವರು ಆದಿಗುರು ಶಿವ ದಕ್ಷಿಣಾಮೂರ್ತಿ ರೂಪದಲ್ಲಿ ಅಂತದ ಈಗ ನಿಮ್ಮ ಪ್ರಶ್ನೆ ವಾಟ್ ಇಸ್ ದ ಟೀಚಿಂಗ್ ಇನ್ ಸೈಲೆನ್ಸ್ ಶಾಂತಿಯಲ್ಲಿ ಕೂತ್ಕೊಳ್ಳೋದು ಹೇಗೆ ಅಂತ ರಮಣ ಮಹರ್ಷಿಗಳು ಕೂತ್ಕೊಂಡು ಸೈಲೆಂಟಾಗಿ ಕೂತ್ಕೊಂಡ್ರು ಸ್ಯಾಟ್ ಸೈಲೆಂಟ್ ಓಕೆ ಜನ ಬಂದರು ಸಮ್ ಪೀಪಲ್ ಫೌಂಡ್ ಪೀಸ್ ಸಮ್ ಪೀಪಲ್ ಡಿಂಟ್ ಫೈಂಡ್ ಪೀಸ್ ಸಮ್ ಪೀಪಲ್ ಫೆಲ್ಟ್ ಪೀಸ್ಫುಲ್ ಅಂಡ್ ವೆಂಟ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಟೀಚಿಂಗ್ ಇನ್ ಸೈಲೆನ್ಸ್ ಇಸ್ ಕಾಲ್ಡ್ ನಿಧಿಧ್ಯಾಸ ಓಕೆ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಟೀಚಿಂಗ್ ಇನ್ ಸೈಲೆನ್ಸ್ ಇಸ್ ಓನ್ಲಿ ಫಾರ್ ಪೀಪಲ್ ಹೈಯೆಸ್ಟ್ ಲೆವೆಲ್ ಆಫ್ ಕ್ವಾಲಿಫೈಡ್ ಪೀಪಲ್ ಕಾಲ್ಡ್ ಭೇದ ಅಭೇದ ಓಕೆ ಸೊ ದ್ಯಾಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಕಾಲ್ಡ್ ಅಭೇದ ದಟ್ಸ್ ಕಾಲ್ಡ್ ನಿಧಿಧ್ಯಾಸ ಸೊ ದಕ್ಷಿಣಾಮೂರ್ತಿ ಟಾಟ್ ನಿಧಿಧ್ಯಾಸ ಟು ದಿ ಹೈಯೆಸ್ಟ್ ಲೆವೆಲ್ ಆಫ್ ಸೀಕರ್ಸ್ ದಟ್ಸ್ ದಿ ಮೀನಿಂಗ್ ಆಫ್ ಟೀಚಿಂಗ್ ಇನ್ ಸೈಲೆನ್ಸ್ ದಕ್ಷಿಣಾಮೂರ್ತಿ ಏನು ಮಾಡಿದ್ರು ನಿಧಿಧ್ಯಾಸ ಮಾಡುವ ಪದ್ಧತಿಯನ್ನು ಯಾರು ಆ ಹಂತಕ್ಕೆ ಬಂದ ಸಾಧಕರಿಗೆ ಹೇಳ್ಬೋದು ಅದಕ್ಕೆ ದಕ್ಷಿಣಾಮೂರ್ತಿ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳೋದು ಅನ್ಶೂರ್ ನಿಧಿಧ್ಯಾಸ ಮೀನ್ಸ್ ಕಂಪ್ಲೀಟ್ ನಾನ್ ಡೂಯಿಂಗ್ ಸೈಲೆನ್ಸ್ ಮೀನ್ಸ್ ಕಂಪ್ಲೀಟ್ ನಾನ್ ಟೀಚಿಂಗ್ ವರ್ಬಲ್ ಸೊ ಯು ರಿಸೀವ್ ದಿ ಸೈಲೆನ್ಸ್ ಇನ್ ನಿಧಿಧ್ಯಾಸ ಬಟ್ ನಾಟ್ ಮೆನಿ ಪೀಪಲ್ ಆರ್ ಕ್ವಾಲಿಫೈಡ್ ಫಾರ್ ದಟ್ ಟೀಚಿಂಗ್ ಹೆಚ್ಚಿನವರಿಗೆ ಆಗಲ್ಲ ದೆನ್ ಯು ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಟು ಗೋ ಟು ಕರ್ಮ ಮಾರ್ಗ ಭೇದ 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 ಪೂಜಾ ಕರ್ಮಯೋಗ ಭಕ್ತಿಯೋಗ ಯು ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಟು ಕಮ್ ಫೈನಲಿ ಕಮ್ ಟು Did I answer your question? Any doubts?
Thank you.
Clear?
Looks clear.
Looks clear, not clear.
Clear.
Okay. So let us meditate for some time.
I got answer. I had asked one question for the long
time. What is the question you asked?
I asked for a question. You are in my dream one day.
Uh-huh.
Then you, Then I said, no message.
Silence.
Silence is the message.
Yes.
Today I got the clear.
Very good. Let us go. Meditate. Light up, Martha.
One doubt.
One doubt, yeah.
This Abheda, Nirvidyas Nirvidyas Kuda, even Ramana Maharshi himself established a temple for his mother and people. So, he still continued to do that.
Who still?
Ramana Maharshi.
He still continues to do in who, what?
I mean, he made a temple for his
mother. No, what is, what he continued to do?
Pujas and other things.
Yeah, that is for there are three types of seekers.
Oh,
he said Arunachala is the Parvata for the first type of seeker. You go around that. For a person who is come to final stage, Arunachala is the Satma. So it depends on the who is.
So that means you mean to say the realized people, they still continue to build temples, do worships and pujas.
See, Shankaracharya.
For the other.
See, yena agutte society ali. ಭೇದ ಭಾವದಲ್ಲಿರೋರು 95% 95% ಅವರಿಗೆ ಯು ಟು ಎಸ್ಟಾಬ್ಲಿಷ್ ಸಿಸ್ಟಮ್ ದಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಪೂಜಾ ಟೆಂಪಲ್ ಯಾತ್ರಾ ಅದಕ್ಕೆ ಶಂಕರಾಚಾರ್ಯ ಅಷ್ಟು ಮಠಗಳನ್ನು ಸ್ಥಾಪನೆ ಮಾಡಿದ್ರು ಪೂಜೆ ಸಿಸ್ಟಮ್ ದೆನ್ ಭೇದ ಭೇದಕ್ಕೆ ಬರೋರು 4.5% ಅವರಿಗೆ ಜಪ ಮ್ಯಾನ ಯೋಗ ಕಡೆ ಜ್ಞಾನಕ್ಕೆ ಬರೋರು 0.1% ನಾವು ಬರೀ 0.1% ನಾನು ಹೇಳ್ತೇನೆ ಬೇರೆಯವರಿಗೆ ಆಗಲ್ಲಂತಿಲ್ಲ ಯು ಟು ಎಸ್ಟಾಬ್ಲಿಷ್ ಫಾರ್ ಅ ಸಿಸ್ಟಮ್ ಫಾರ್ ಆಲ್ ದಿ ಪೀಪಲ್ ರೈಟ್ ಎಸ್ ವಾಟ್ ಅದೇನಾಗುತ್ತೆ ಜನರು ನಿಧಾನವಾಗಿ ಮುಂದೆ ಬರ್ತಾರೆ ರಮಣ ಮಹರ್ಷಿ ಮಾಡಿದ್ರೆ ಯಾಕೆ ಅದನ್ನು ಮಾಡಿ ಜನ ಬೇಕಲ್ಲ ಜನರಿಗೆ ಬೇಡ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳೋಕ್ಕಾಗತ್ತಾ ಎಲ್ಲರೂ ಬರ್ತಾರೆ ನಿಮ್ಮ ಮಾರ್ಗ ಅಪ್ಪ ಮಾಡಿ ಕಡೆಗೆ ನಿಮಗೆ ಅರುಣಾಚಲ ಪ್ರದರ್ಶನ ಮಾಡಿ ಸಾಕು ಅರುಣಾಚಲ ನಿಧವಾಗಿ ನೋಡಿದ ಆತ್ಮ ಅದನ್ನು ಅದು ಎಷ್ಟು ನಿಮಗೆ ಹೇಳ್ತಾಗುತ್ತೆ ಹಾಗೆ ದ ಟೀಚಿಂಗ್ ಹ್ಯಾಸ್ ತ್ರೀ ಲೆವೆಲ್ಸ್ ಇಫ್ ಯು ಡೋಂಟ್ ಅಂಡರ್ಸ್ಟ್ಯಾಂಡ್ ಟೀಚಿಂಗ್ ಆಫ್ ತ್ರೀ ಲೆವೆಲ್ಸ್ ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಮಿಸ್ಅಂಡರ್ಸ್ಟ್ಯಾಂಡ್ ಟೀಚಿಂಗ್ I am quoting exact words of Shiva. Beda, 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 Abheda. And what exactly is to be done for each of them, he has told very clearly to Parvati. Okay. Ramana Shivoham.
Ramana Shivoham.
Ramana Shivoham.
Ramana Shivoham.
Ramana Shivoham.
ರಮಣ ಶಿವೋಹಂ 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 ಅಮ್ಮ ಏಕ ನಿಮಿಷ ಕಟ್ಕೊಳ್ತಾ ವಾಪಸ್ ಕರ್ತಾ